Hey, welcome back to the channel. So I'm fixing to go pick up my dog from the vet, which is always a pretty crazy experience. A poor old dog, she got diabetes, and then the diabetes caused her to go blind, develop cataracts. So we're gonna get the cataracts taken care of. And to be able to get the cataracts taken care of, we have to take her in for teeth cleaning. You know, she's only about 5 or 6 years old, fairly young dog. Really feel sorry for her, you know, going blind. It's kind of a bad thing to watch, you know, like to see her kind of process that she can't see what she used to be able to see. It's kind of sad. So, you know,
of course,
we're going to get taken care of.
How you doing?
That's it. Her eye surgery is coming up here in a couple of weeks. But this is the first step, and I'm fixing to pick her up from the vet. Hopefully she'll be excited. I don't know. She might be completely drugged out. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what she is doing. Going tonight to the holiday parade, Christmas parade here in Stillwater. I'm going to film what I can of it with the FX30. I'm not really completely 100% sold on the FX30 quite yet. I really want to take down my A7S3 and film this particular parade with it, but I want to give the FX30 a shot because I want to give it a good test to see if I want to keep it or not. Just not quite sold on it yet. But I got a chance to go out to that parade the other night. Boy, I was really struggling whether to take my full frame camera or the FX30. But I wanted to see what the FX30 would do in low light. So I went ahead and took it out. The FX30 did a really, really good job filming this parade. I mean, it was, as you can see, like super low light situation. I mean, it's practically dark. I didn't use log, I just used S-Cinetone. I think all the footage just looks great. Just like you expect a Sony camera to look. Like the low light was good on it, even though the ISO was up around 6400 or so. It had great autofocus. The picture looks fine to me. A lot of people complain about the colors of the Sony. I think they look great. I think the camera overall did great. And then let's go ahead and look at some of the pictures that I took. Like, there's been a lot of discussion about, you know, the FX30 not being a great photography camera. And it's not, you know, you can only get single shot mode on it. But I took some pictures while I was messing around there, and I'll show you those. And I edited these pictures, and I think they come out pretty good. I don't think the FX30 is obviously not going to win any awards. You know, it's not like an award-winning photo camera or anything. But it'll get the job done as long as you're not trying to shoot a bunch of action or things like that. If you're just out taking snapshots, family, you know, easy photo shots, I think the FX30 will come in, will do a great job at that. You know, if you already have the A7 IV, would it be worth it to get the FX30, you know? Yeah, you can just put your APS-C lenses straight on this A7 IV. You get 4K, 60 frames per second. The only thing you're missing out is 4K, 120 frames per second, 240 frames per second in HD. If I was just gonna have one, I would save up and get the A7 IV. But I've been looking for a APS-C camera for a while now. I have a bunch of APS-C lenses. I started out off on APS-C. I've since got this ZV-E10. The ZV-E10 just didn't do it for me. I mean, I'm just not a big fan of the ZV-E10. Mainly because I cannot hold the shot steady at all while shooting video. Sony will definitely come out with a better APS-C photo camera in the next coming months. I would guess within six to eight months, they would come out with a A6700 or A7000 or whatever you wanna call it, but it won't have the video specs of this camera, that's for sure. And if you start kind of looking at the pricing of the APS-C, you know, where exactly are they gonna go? I mean, they may put that camera in at, you know, $1,700, $1,600, something like that. And it's not gonna be just a whole lot cheaper, if any at all, than the FX30. If you ask me, that's kind of what's gonna happen there. I'm gravitating more towards the video specs of the FX30 over the potential photo specs of the A7000 or whatever they're gonna call it. So going back to the, whether you wanna use the FX30 or the A7 IV, if you ask me, the FX30 is a little more inconspicuous. Like, if you roll up with A7 IV in your hands, people are going to start, you know, you're going to be the camera guy. There's no question about it. It's a professional camera. It's a professional looking camera. So when you roll up in one of these, people are going to start, you know, taking notice. If you ask me, the FX30, even though it has pretty much the same specs, I mean, only a camera person would know that, it's going to look a lot less inconspicuous than an A7IV. I don't know why, just that old camera hump is pretty much the only thing that's different in it. But it's gonna do a lot better job of not sticking out in the crowd than the A7IV. The only thing you might want to think about if you're trying to remain inconspicuous a little bit is to turn off some of the tally lights. Because when you go to record and that camera just lights up, especially if you're in a dark space, it just lights up like a Christmas tree. All these tally lights on. I personally enjoy them. I think they're good to have, and I'll have them on for most of the time. But if you want to kind of be keep on the down low, you might want to turn some of those off, because man, the camera just lights up like crazy when you start recording. I think it's going to be a great camera for me overall. It's going to fit into my little system I got going on, my little collection. It's going to fit in real nice. So, and autofocus is just great. I mean, it's like boom right on my eye the whole time. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.
That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright.
Oh, look at that bulldog.